of Harry Potter over at Universal Studios Hollywood, baby. Yeah. All right. We're going to try this out today. I'm trying out a brand new device that hopefully will help with the streams and whatnot. But there it is. Hogwarts Castle. Oh, my goodness. Yes. So lovely. I love this music, too. A little bit of that John Williams goodness. My thought tonight was maybe just kind of walk around. Enjoy all the goodness that is the Wizarding World. The heavy theming, the fun times, you know, the memories, all of that. And we're going to go check it out. You're coming with. All right, let's go. Go for a little walk. Hello, how are you?
Doing good.
Dude, doing great work. Thank you. Oh, yeah. Backside of Ollivander's here. So in the beginning of the day, I usually see this a little bit busier, to be honest with you. Yep. A lot of people want to come here, get their wands and whatnot. And as you can see over here, hopefully, this is the extended queue line they have for Forbidden Journey. I don't know how often they actually use this. It's probably more for not only like spring break, but the summertime when we get peak crowds and whatnot. Yeah, right here. Ooh, isn't it beautiful? I love it. It's so good. If you're watching this live, please let me know if you can see everything. If it sounds good, looks good. There's a good chance some family's watching tonight. They might not be signed in on YouTube, so they're probably like, we can't message you. So if that's the case, then I apologize. But I appreciate you tuning in either way. Yeah, here we go. Take a little walk around. This little stage over here where they perform various different acts. I like the Toad Choir, but I haven't seen that in a long time. Yeah. There we go. Just gonna walk over here next to Forbidden Journey. We're not gonna go on the actual ride because, well, we can't with the phone. That'd be pretty intense. And I just wrote it earlier. So that's probably enough for one day. Yeah. One is definitely enough for one day. For sure. There's a lot of people over here. Seems to be a bit of a choke point. That's okay, as long as we don't trip, break anything, break anyone. Or like, yeah, let's find a good spot to set up shop for a second here. Oh yes. You hear that flight of the hippogriff right over next to us here. Make sure all this is working. Yep. I think so. Okay. Yep. Okay, cool. Excellent. It's a beautiful night here, though. Sun is setting. Hogsmeade's looking good. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I was actually on this earlier today. Uh-oh. What's mom saying? Mom? My mom's like, now? Are you doing it now? Yes, I am doing it now. Can I answer a text while live streaming? I don't know. We're going to find out together. Hold on, everybody. We're back, everybody. We're back. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, there goes Flight of the Hippogriff. We're going to wait 1 second because another one's going to come around really shortly. Good stuff, man. I like it. Just set this up and walk around and be like, doo, 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 doo. Come on. So they have two trains typically going, so they'll have one going around while they load the other one, and then they'll send off the other one typically around the same time that the other one gets back to the station. So it's decently efficient for what it is. It's not a huge roller coaster. Again, it's pretty small, but yeah. Okay. Oh, here we go. There we go. Look at them go. Up and up and up and up and up. Here they go. It doesn't look that intense, but it's actually much more intense than you'd think. Yay, there they go. Have fun, guys, bye. They're having a good time. They're having a good time. I like it. Like I said, if you're watching this live, please let me know. Let me know if you can hear me, see me and all that stuff, if it looks good or if it looks choppy or whatnot. Again, Mom, if you are watching and you are not signed in, you will not be able to comment. So if you're like, I can't say anything. All right, we're going to walk into Hogsmeade, though, because I want to go check some stuff out. But again, if anybody here is watching this live, let me know where you want to go. I just figured we'd start here, because it's the Wizarding World. And again, look at that castle. Beautiful. Oh. It's like it's even hard for me to comprehend standing here, like looking at it. That's forced perspective done correctly right there, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, I love it. I love it. Good stuff. There we go. Here's a question for you guys watching. Butterbeer, where do we land on? Hot, cold, frozen? What's your preferred version? I am more of a hot butterbeer man myself. Northman as it is. You know? Just like the hot butterbeer. I probably won't get it today. It was about 100 degrees. That's 100 degrees Fahrenheit. So, not really the day for a hot butterbeer. Might rip me apart from the inside. Yes, the butterbeer line's typically really, really long. Yeah. But this is one place you can get butterbeer. There's a lot of different places to get butterbeer here. That's one. There are two other places I know of down over here. The Hogshead and the actual Three Broomsticks itself. Yeah. And again, if you guys want to see any specific shops, I'm just going to probably dip into one at some point here. This is usually the busiest spot in the park, though. Like, everybody's coming here. Wizarding World. Very popular. Very, very popular. And the bathroom's over there where you can hear Moaning Myrtle. It's upsetting. Oh, thank you for the like. I don't know who gave me that, but thank you. Again, if you are watching live, let me know if this looks good or not. We're trying it horizontal today, trying the new holding, the handhold device. So, yes. I think we're going to pop into Honey Dukes just to look around at some candy. Yeah. Take a little peek-see at some candy. Oh, I can go for some candy. Let's show some restraint. Oh yeah, here are the Three Broomsticks right here. So good. Hey! Hi, Niecy and Janice and Bill. Guys, let me know. Can you hear and see everything all right? How's it look? Does it look choppy? Let me know. Oh, is this like exit only right now? Maybe, maybe not. I don't know. Let's see. Hello. Hi. Excellent. Okay. Get one of these down here. These are chocolate frogs. The only problem I have with them, do you guys want to take a guess? I think they're $15. Oh my goodness, $25. Whoop. Put that back gently. And you give a little pat pat, you know? You love the chocolate frogs. Oh my goodness. Yes. Fudge flies? What's a fudge fly? I don't even know. Oh, yeah. Fudge flies. These seem very strange. Did you get this with a chocolate frog? Can I get like a combo pack? $10. Okay. And then you could try your luck with the birdie bots. You know, never know what you're going to get. Nice. Yeah. Jelly slugs. Oh my gosh. This is Bill's favorite. Bill, who's watching right now. Bill loves the jelly slugs. Best Buy next December. I'm trying to see the prices on all these. I'm so sorry, everybody. It's jelly slugs. Delicious. Not jelly worms, jelly slugs. I like it. Actually, really like that a lot. Yeah, the theming in here is pretty unmatched. It's so good. Yeah. And it gets a little hectic. If you guys want me to buy you some candy, just let me know. I'm just kidding. Bill's so jealous right now. Bill, get over here. Bill, look at my face. Bill, look at this face. Bill, hi. Come here. Come on, let's go. Come on, Jurassic Park. Look at this. I got my little annual pass, too. Yeah. Okay, sorry. Back to the show. Okay. Yes, some more of the chocolate frogs. I want one. They're $25? I thought it was only $15. There's no way that jumped up $10 since last time I was here, right? Is inflation that crazy? Can inflation be that crazy? Yeah, I'm gonna move this over a little bit so I can see your comments a little bit better. Oh, there we go. Woo! Nice. Here we go. Yes. So this is Honey Dukes. Honey Dukes, you can get a bunch of stuff here, not only candy. I think there's even ice cream. We'll sneak through, see if we can. Oh, no, they've got like fudge and stuff. Oh, I love fudge. I may have sold them. Yes, let's go, Bill. They make Oreo fudge like me. Oh my gosh. Guys, I make Oreo fudge. Check out QCTV. Oreo fudge. I made some Oreo fudge. That's amazing.
Thank you.
Cool. That's wonderful. Okay, so not necessarily ice cream. Yeah. And because they don't have Diagon Alley here, they have kind of like a smaller version. This isn't like the Weasley's Wizarding Wheezes per se, but this is kind of what you get over there. I think it's Zonko's. Also, where's Diagon Alley? Yeah, I know. Universal's watching right now. Oh my lord. Things are moving around here real fast. Very scary. Very frightening. Oh, look, you can look like a little wolf. Gotta check this out. Hello, friend. How much are you? Oh, a paltry $35. Oh, you're so cool. I love you. Hi. If my mom were here right now, well, she probably wouldn't want you, but I would. Walk away, Jim. Walk away before you get too attached. Yeah, let's check this out. You don't like the chocolate frogs? You can get a peppermint toad. Don't worry. Yeah. I don't know what the price is. Oh, $10 on this. Yeah. Okay. So you get like 2.5 of those for one chocolate frog. I don't know if they do halves, but pretty cool. Yeah. All right, now we're going to sneak out. Head across the street to the train station. Oh no, it's closed for the night. Oh, I'm sorry, Mac, who's watching. Mac, this is gonna be for you. Mac, I'm gonna show you a big train. It's okay. We're still gonna sneak through. We're gonna look at the train. The Hogwarts Express, ladies and gentlemen. Now, the Hogwarts Express down at Islands of Adventure goes between that park and the Universal Studios Florida park, is how you get from one park to the other, the Harry Potter way. If you have a park hopper, that is. Here, it's just a photo op, and you can meet up with the train conductor. However, also, you can get the Hogsmeade station over here, which is usually open. I guess it shuts down early, but we can take a little peek in. Pretty cool. I should cover this on one of my last Universal vlogs. I kind of walked into every shop, but I didn't know this one existed for so long. And what I really want is I want some of this, like that luggage. How cool would you be with that luggage? You got a 9 3/4 pillow? Look at that. And they'll give you the whole pillow, too, even if you only pay for 9 3/4 of it. Oh! I'm sorry. These are horrible jokes. These are the jokes, folks. Now you can appreciate the magic snow, because it's 100 degrees out here, or it was earlier, but the snow is still going strong. Yeah. It's wonderful. Mm-hmm. To go back in, we'll look at some more shops and whatnot. Again, like I said before, please feel free to comment if there's things you want to see, stuff you want to tell me, questions you want to ask. Levy them at me. I can handle it. I can take it. Yeah, this place is hopping. And thankfully, this park is open until 9 o'clock tonight. Usually, it's like 7 or so. But I like to come here when it's open a little later, quote unquote later. We're going to head into the Owl Post here. This is some of my favorite theming in the whole of the Wizarding World. As you come in here, it's the post office, and you can actually look up here, and you can see the owls. Look at that. Let's see, can we name some? It's a great horned owl, I think. Those kind of look like big, big barn owls. Yeah. Oh, so cool, though. This is where I deliver all of my letters and packages. No, I'm just kidding. It's wonderful. So cool. Oh. Here we go. Watch with Don, Livy, and Mac. Hey, Mom, how you doing? Thank you. Hi, guys. How are you? Hello. Okay. We're gonna look at this. Look at this guy right here, this book.
Oh, also, hello to you.
You're like, who's he talking to? What's that guy doing? This guy's just a sleepy book. There he is. Hello. Want to say hi to everybody? Yeah, he's doing okay. Yeah. We'll just leave him. We'll let him rest. Now, I always ask this, but which house are you? Are you Gryffindor? Are you Slytherin? Ravenclaw? Hufflepuff? Which one? Yeah, I am a mighty brave Gryffindor, believe it or not. But there's something to be said for the other houses. A cunning Slytherin, not so bad. An intelligent Ravenclaw. And then a friendly Hufflepuff. Most of the people I know, I think I could sort them properly, but who knows? Maybe there's something you guys aren't telling me. Maybe all you Hufflepuffs are actually Slytherins in disguise. Now that'd be pretty impressive. But again, look at the theming. We look up, and we have brooms. Actual brooms flying there. Now, which one's the Nimbus 2000? Which one's the Firebolt? I remember the Firebolt feeling like a big upgrade in the books. I was like, I want a Firebolt. Ah, it's so cool. Yeah, all that extra theming they didn't need to put in there, but they do. And you know what? I appreciate it. I'm not a huge fan of stripes. You guys like stripes on your shirts? Oh, you can get like little belts and everything. Or little, not belts. What are these? Help me out here. What are these called? Suspenders. Suspenders, that's what they are. I figured it out. I'm a clever boy. You get little pins and stuff too. I like the little Ravenclaw. It's pretty cute. Oh, you can get like a little chocolate frog. Aww. That's nice. Okay, wait, here's a real question. How much does this cost compared to a regular chocolate frog? Oh, this is $15. Okay, so you can get a permanent chocolate frog, $10 less. So think about it. Think about it. Where are the jelly beans, Mom? We just went past the jelly beans. I can go back to them if you want. Here, I gotta say hi to Mom first. No, she's here. Mom, hello. Hi, hello. How you doing? We're just walking around. She's like, where are the jelly beans? Go back to the jelly beans. I was telling you. Gryffindor. Rock on. Okay, back to the show. I keep saying back to the show like I'm not part of the show. I'm just the man behind the camera. I'm just kidding. I'm trying to be in front of the camera. Oh, I've looked at these before. These are kind of cool. I like these. These are fun. I don't know if these are turvises, tumblers. Somebody help me out on that. We were trying to get on the chat. No, Mom, no worries. We can go back and look at the jelly beans if you want. You are most important. Go buy yourself a little baby broom. Light up broom. All right. Okay, last time I was here, they had it where you could put your name on the back of these. I don't know if they're still allowing that or not. Let's take a little look, see. Oh no, this one just says Potter. Yeah, Potter is 7. Okay, does it say Malfoy? That one does say Malfoy, oh my gosh. Okay, what's Ravenclaw then? Chang, Cho Chang, and this is gonna be Cedric Diggory, right? Yeah, Diggory, totally. Hey, hi to Mom Mac, yeah, Niecy's here. Oh my gosh. Hey, what's Caden? Anytime somebody pops in and says hi to me, I'm gonna say hi. Like, hi. Hey, Caden, how you doing, buddy? Thank you for dropping by. Appreciate it so much. Thank you. Like I keep telling everybody joining up, you can hear the music. Yeah, the music is so good here. Man, the John Williams was crushing it. Here, we're gonna look at some more of this stuff. We're gonna go look at the robes and whatnot. So you can get some of these sweet, sweet threads. I think they're like, yeah, what, $139 for these? Which is pretty, it's a lot. But what I love about this room specifically, check this out. Look at this, look at all that theming. Tailoring, while you wait. All this stuff, magic. Just for comparison's sake, I think Disney's Jedi robes and Sith robes specifically are like $200? But they're a bit different, right? Just so you guys know. Alright, Mom wanted to see the jelly beans, so we're gonna go back to the jelly beans just really quickly. They'll probably sneak into Ollivander's for a second. It's so much fun. Thanks for walking around the park with me, guys. It's so much better than walk around alone. Yeah. Ah, yes. A night is starting to descend on Hogsmeade. I love it. I love Hogsmeade. After we go into Honeydukes again for a second, we're gonna pop into the three broomsticks so you guys can see some of the just, oh, such cool theming. All right, Ma, this is for you. Oh, hold on a sec. My buddy Sirius is in the papers again. Gosh, dude, stop doing that. It looks bad, all right? It's bad for your image. It's bad for your image. Oh, you can see another spot where they're getting out the good old butterbeer. I almost got a honey beer. Butterbeer looks like the slush version too, like the cold. They're doing all of it. Yeah. It's bumping. It's bumping. I'm gonna sneak back in this way. Whoa. Hello again. Okay, Ma, here's what you wanted. Here are the jelly beans. The birdie bots. Yeah. So you can get these and you never know what you're gonna get. Oh, Honey Duke just is a milk chocolate.
Whoa.
Something's happening. We have to go see it. Yay! Is it a birthday? Maybe? I think that's everything. Okay, something just happened. He ordered something or it was his birthday. I thought we were under attack. But anyway, like I was saying, Honey Duke's milk chocolate. What if I got like a golden ticket? Oh, it says October 30th, 2022. I thought it said 2021 for a second. I was like, amazing. This can't be that expensive. I'm tempted to pick up some of this. I love just straight up chocolate. I'm a milk chocolate boy. I wonder how much I could ask to pay for this. Don't you wish you were pushing Nisi around in a wheelchair right now? That is, I'm always, always wishing that every single day. Now, one thing that's really cool, I think they're bringing it back now. That is actually building your own birdie bots, every flavored beans. It's really cool. I think that's a thing. Maybe, I'm not sure. But I hope it is. And if it isn't right now, it will be again one day. That's so cool, because you can see kind of like the little spot where they were supposed to be. A live butterbeer review? Oh my gosh, we could try. That'd be hard to do. I was just telling people earlier, Caden, that I love the hot butterbeer. That might be a bad idea right now, because it's like 100 degrees, or it was, so it's like probably 80 now. I'm not kidding. We're gonna head on into the Three Broomsticks though, because I wanna show you guys this place. It's so much fun to hang out in here. And I did have a hot butterbeer in here recently, and I just hung out by myself. Check this out. Oh my gosh, the smells in here, baby. Oh, baby. So good. Like, I don't know if I can impress upon you. It's a lot darker in here than the camera sets it up to be. But it's lovely. It's so good. We're gonna walk around just a little bit. Unfortunately, we can't go upstairs because there's no upstairs to go up to, even though it looks like there is. That'd be so cool if we could. But I sat over here. Hello. I sat right there and enjoyed a butterbeer all by myself. If you can see up in here, look at this. Oh, so good. I love it. I love it so. Yeah. And check this out. One of my favorite things. This is the Hog's Head. The bar attached over here. And if you look right over here, you can see the actual Hog's Head. You see it back there? It's moving around. Yeah. I love you. Hey, buddy. You're cool. So cool. Ugh. Ah, so cool. Yeah, it's such good theming. It's the best. Totally. Janice, are you on comms right now? Hi, Janice.
Hi.
Again, thank you guys for joining me. I hope this all looks and sounds good. Please be brutally honest. I need to make this better because I'm going to try to stream more from the parks. Yeah. It's just beautiful in here. It's just so, so pretty. Were we serious about the butterbeer thing? Does anybody else want to see me try that? I could do it. We could do a cold one, I guess. Or a frozen one. So I burn my mouth right now. It's going to be like the rest of my body. Just fried. Oh my gosh, I didn't notice that beaming up there before. Like that. What? Like, oh my gosh. There's so much. There's so much. I could walk into this place 10 times. I almost have already. And see something brand new every time. Like the piping and everything. Ah, Janice, just working for the weekend. She's like, I am up past my normal bedtime. Well done, Janice. Well done. Look at that spiral staircase. I'd kill to have one of those. I'm just kidding. I wouldn't kill to have one. I like the spiral staircase, though. I really do. Just so nice in here. Ugh. My goodness. Maybe I could walk you guys through the castle. Would you guys like to see the castle? Let me know. If I get like one or two people saying they want to see a castle walkthrough, I could probably do it. We'll see how long the line is, but maybe they would just let me walk through. And I could just show it to you guys. Because that'd be kind of fun. Yeah. Alright, we're going to keep moving on though. Back outside. Wow, it is. It doesn't remind me completely of Florida, because in Florida the humidity would be like so crazy high. So this isn't so bad. Mm-hmm. I was hoping we get like one of the stage shows too, so I could show you guys. Just thought that'd be really cool. Just like you look in any window here, and there's something cool to see. Like, I got little owls. Oh my gosh, look at that chunky little fluffer. Oh, if Katie were here right now. These are really cute. I love it. Just so much theming. Wonderful. Wunderbar. Uh-oh, levitating dresses. Oh my gosh, what is this? Dead man's chest? Anybody catch that reference? Okay. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Got the quaffles over there. Where they do the stage shows, as I was pointing out earlier. Doesn't look like they're doing any soon, because usually they have somebody up there kind of making sure people aren't walking up there. It's a cool little spot. I like it. Mom, what's a quaffle? That is the big red... Oh, actually, those were bludgers, too, but a quaffle is actually the big red ball that they use in Quidditch. It's the main ball. What did I miss this? I miss some chats here? Hold on. Live chat. Let me see. Do you see the castle? Oh. Mrs. Barathe Lane? Is that... I don't know if that's how it would go. Oh, my gosh. Harry Potter and the Forbidden Journey. Only 10 minutes? Yeah, we should be able to walk this. I'll go ask. Do you want to see the castle? You got it. I just gotta ask real polite like. I don't know why I said it that way. I feel like we got some Texans watching. Or one, well, two Texans. All right, here we go. Castle walkthrough. Might run into a little bit of a line here, but now again, this attraction, they don't let you usually bring anything on here. They have lockers. And I'm just gonna say, I'm going through a castle walkthrough, which means that you go through just like the regular queue line. And you don't get on the ride. So, I'll just go tell them. Yeah, these guys, I think they're doing the same thing. Bless you. Riders, that's a rider line. Hi, castle walkthrough.
Oh, okay. You can go, you want to go for express or regular line?
Just regular's fine. Thank you, appreciate it. All right. I have many actors around dressed as wizards. Not a ton, I mean, most of the people working here are considered that. Here, you guys go pass. Go for it.
Thank you.
Yeah, enjoy. Go say hi to Harry for me, all right? So, here we go. I'm going to walk you guys through. Now, if you look right here, we have the mirror you see in the very beginning. Well, actually, well, the beginning of all the Harry Potters, but I should say at the end or midway point through Sorcerer's Stone. You see, this is the same mirror that Harry looks in the Philosopher's Stone or Sorcerer's Stone, depending on the version. That's what you see. Yeah, pretty cool. But if we turn around, I still don't know who this guy is. I've been trying to figure it out. Look at him. He's like, hello. I think he said, give me liberty or give me death. That's what he said. We start off down here in the dungeons of Hogwarts, kind of near the potion storeroom. Yeah, my potions class. You guys remember potions, right? Seems like a weird class to teach children. That's okay. People love potions, witches and wizards. Now, on an upcoming vlog, I have all of this too, so it'll probably be a little crisper. But I ended up waiting in the regular line for it, which is really funny. Oh yeah, here, let me show you this too. I'm gonna sneak over here so I can kind of show you the ride vehicle, because if you guys want to know what it sits like, this is what it is. So this is the ride vehicle for this attraction, but it's actually one part of a bench. There's one, two, three, four in a little segment together. So you kind of sit and you're on the top of like a cherry picker. So you kind of move around like this and then you'll kind of crank backwards and stuff. So yeah, also professional. I don't know if you're talking about me, but I appreciate that. But yeah, now we're actually walking into the herbology classroom. Oh yes, and we've got mandrakes to see, baby. Who doesn't love a good old fashioned mandrake? I don't know. It's a rhetorical question. It's kind of a quiet night here though. 10 minutes for this? This is kind of nuts. Okay. Again, if you have any questions, guys, or you want me to stop and look at something a little bit longer, please don't hesitate to ask. This ride, it's intense. There's a lot of warnings. It's like, ah! Bill's favorite? Oh my gosh, Bill, I wrote it today. Again. I've done it twice in 1 week, and I feel very, very proud. The last time I was here, I got stopped right here. And it was like, oh, it's a 70 or 80 minute wait. And I was like, I just want to do the castle walkthrough. It's only like 40 minutes, thankfully. Yeah, this was all filled up. They thankfully have some drinking fountains, though. They're very considerate, witches and wizards. Yep. We're going to take our time when we get up here. We got some switchbacks to take care of first. Again, thank you everybody for being here tonight. I really appreciate it. Really, really do. Thank you. Okay. And you can see that's the tram tour down there. Yeah. Pretty cool. The music is just top tier. Tippity top tier. Mm-hmm. Now, it's not all John Williams music, too. The main theme is, definitely, from the earlier films as well. Most of that music is John. But later on, we have some other composers like this one you're hearing right now. I don't believe it was John Williams. Could be wrong on that. So this is what I would consider to be maybe one of the more boring parts of the queue. Switchbacks right there. And then after this, it's all golden. See, everybody can turn and go right in here, but we're not doing that. No, 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 no. We're gonna go check out those mandrakes, baby. Okay. There we go, we're going through switchbacks. You guys aren't gonna tell, because I'm gonna just try to hold it steady. Here we go. Oh my gosh, it's so hard to do. Okay, here we go. Look at these little guys and gals. Aw, they're really cute. Yeah, the little ones that scream. Yep, you guys remember the ones? I think they're called mandrakes. I think that's what they're called. If someone could tell me opposite, or be like, Jimmy, no, they're not mandrakes. They've never been mandrakes. Are you crazy? But I want to show you guys something else that most people don't see, okay? Everybody's looking at the mandrakes, right? Oh, actually, I'm going to get trapped in this queue. Okay, this is John Williams, by the way. So good. All right, so we just looked at those mandrakes. Now we're cutting back through the switchbacks. However, I might be wrong about this. But I'm pretty sure it's kind of hard to tell, and I don't know if it's totally true, but I think we even have some in there. They're mandrakes. Okay, thank you. I'm pretty positive, like, there might be one in here or something. Maybe I just made that up. I don't know. That's what I'm telling people, though. All right? We're going in. You guys ready for a little bit of that Hogwarts action? Here we go. Brace yourselves. This is where the attraction really kicks off in earnest. Oh my gosh, look at that griffin. Oh, it's begging to be said hello to. If you come over here, you can actually see the beginnings of the school. I forget if this is Mr. Hogwarts himself. I don't think that's true. But we have, right here, you're probably looking like, okay, I've got Gryffindor and Hufflepuff. But where the heck are Ravenclaw and Slytherin? Well, don't worry, they haven't forgotten about you, because we definitely have both of those. We have Ravenclaw right over there, the Raven's there. And of course, the sneakiest, slyest of them all. Hello. A little Slytherin action down there, baby, yeah. Now, one thing, everybody's looking over here at the statues, and you'll see this throughout the actual queue itself, but I love these blue, kind of purplish tinted windows. They are always like this, so when you walk in, it just immediately feels like it's nighttime. So good. Yeah. Joe is here. Joe, how you doing, buddy? Joe, I'll hit you up later online there, pal. This door, actually.
You guys go on.
Sorry, thank you. This door actually leads into the eighth book, the ninth film, is right behind this door.
Yep.
So they keep the manuscript. Yep, and I know what you're thinking. Jimmy, they have the Fantastic Beasts. No, 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 I'm not talking about a prequel. I'm talking about a sequel. I'm like 90% positive this is Salazar Slytherin. Someone help me in the comments. I'm not sure. And over here, we have a lovely tapestry of a unicorn, circa 1745. Yes. I don't know, just made that up. But again, we're seeing another one of those windows. That's some theming right there, baby. But really, we're coming back to it. We're going into Albus Dumbledore's office. Look at this griffin. And as I mentioned in this upcoming video, griffins are my absolute favorite mythical creature. Please let me know which ones yours are, too. I'd love to hear about this, but I love griffins. I love them more than dragons. I'm going to make a new thing where griffins breathe lightning. That's my new thing, but I love griffins. They're so cool. Oh, just the patriot in me, you know? I love eagles. Okay. Yes, look at this. Oh, here, let's do like a little... I'm just going to class. Which way's charms? Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness. Check this out. Here we go. A little moving picture action. Oh, he's gone. Bye. Come back. Oh, Caden, you lovely person. You love, you don't, you know what that gets? You know what that gets from me? It's a little bit of love. I love that, thank you. Yes, Nergigante.
This here, my friends, is a billywig.
Oh, billywig.
Indigenous to Australia.
Oh.
A single sting causes dizziness and levitation.
Whoa.
Allow me to give you an example.
What if we just hit Voldemort with like 1,000 billywigs? Like, what up, Voldemort?
Who would like to join me in my picture for a demonstration?
I'm here. I'd love to. Mm-hmm. Me.
Maybe not. The last guest floated right out the window.
Oh, come on.
The teachers had to curse her down.
Curse her down? What do you mean, like using foul language?
Right. Must get down to the match.
Okay, well, I'll be the same.
Big Quidditch match today.
What a guy. And these moving pictures. Oh, he followed me over here. Oh my god. Smells nice in here.
Gryffindor or Slytherin?
Yeah, go Gryffindor. So cool. Look at those guys. They're watching Quidditch forever. Let's look at this though. A tiny little door. I really like just wherever you look, there's something to look at in this. There's no space that goes without detail. Here's a little kind of overview of Hogwarts, like a map on a quilt. It's maybe hard to see, but it's like the long gallery, middle courtyard, the quad, hanging out with my friends, fellow Gryffindors watching. Meet you at the quad later, buddies. Great hall, all that stuff. The lake. So, is this guy... Is he okay? You okay, bro? What? Oh, the winds. Are they like the? Are these like the winds? Like the? Oh my gosh! It's like all the winds. That's fun. Okay. Now you guys ready for this? Check this out. Oh my gosh! Now I don't know if they ever had moving stairways in here, but it is so cool to look at all of this and how high up it goes. Like you can see these kind of portraits stacked on portraits, you know. There's Godric Gryffindor, I believe. That should be Rowena Ravenclaw. Salazar is here, older. I'm sorry, he's kind of caught in the light. Sorry, Salazar. Hi, buddy. And is it Helena Hufflepuff? How do I know this? How do I?
Yes. Potter. Bellic Crescens wouldn't even make a substitute on the Slytherin team.
You're mad, Salazar. Just watch.
Every time I try to watch somebody, they keep moving.
Young Mr. Potter and Gryffindor beat Slytherin today.
Ha!
Wow.
Gryffindor doesn't stand a chance.
So cool.
Honestly,
all right. Who wants to go say hi to Albus? I think it's time. Go say hi. Now this takes place probably around the fifth movie/book, Order of the Phoenix. Just keep that in mind, because if you're like, why is Albus Dumbledore around? It's probably why. Godric. Yeah, dude. Rock on, dude. Also, like, look at these little divots or whatnot. So good. Here we go. We're going to go say hi to Albus. We're going to look at all the trinkets first, and then we'll go say hi to Albus himself. Albus has all these little things. But you might recognize one of them as the Pensieve. Oh, yes. Take your memories out, put them right in the dish, smash your face into it. And you can relive it. Isn't that fun? Oh my gosh. I'd do this, but it'd be like the vlogs. It's just like, I'm reliving the vlogs. So cool. Almost seems like you wash your hands at it. No, no, muscles. Also, this is where the express comes up. We can go over here, we're gonna go say hi to Albus. Yeah. There he is, Albus. By the four greatest witches and wizards of the world. Here we'll say hi. As many of you may know, Hogwarts is one of the schools where young people in the wizarding world come to study magic. Pretty cool, huh? As you know, things can be a little unpredictable here. Yeah, pretty cool. But it wouldn't be a trip to Hogwarts without saying hi to Harry, Hermione, and Ron, which we should probably go to in the Defense Against the Dark Arts classroom, which is probably my favorite of the whole place. And I'll show you why. We'll go say hi. Hi, guys. Hello. Who's your favorite? And why is it Hermione?
That was a lot of bonus. You can enter the classroom through the blackboard. Anyway, we thought you might rather watch the game of Quidditch than listen to Ben's, but we'll have to sneak you out of the class and down to the pitch. I'm going to recommend the best doing that to follow you there.
Thank you.
All you have to do is follow me to the room requirement, and I'll manage it from there. Of course, we'll need a bit of magic. A charm I learned from a world-class Quidditch player.
Oh.
Mine is famous for a charm.
Ah!
Yes. We saw
Jake's recounting. Hermione.
Remember.
She's so powerful.
Meet Hermione in the room of quiet.
Roger Dodger.
See Ron, everything worked out perfectly.
Okay, Defense Against the Dark Arts. If you want to be a professor at Hogwarts, I recommend do not be a Dark Arts or Defense Against the Dark Arts teacher. You've got like 1 year and then you're done. But here's the reason why I love this room. Check this out. It's like a young dragon or a drake or something. And it's just hanging over the classroom. Isn't that wonderful? You guys might remember this because this classroom is featured in most all the films, I believe. But there's one, I think it's the third one, Prisoner of Azkaban, where they have to fight the Boggarts. And it takes on different forms of what you're afraid of. Mine would be commitment. I don't know what that would look like, probably some sort of cell phone bill. I'd be like, get it out of here! Oh, they're back. Hi, guys.
Excuse me, we recognize your body.
They do different things, though. It's different not every time, but they have like two or three different ones, so it's not always the same, which is great. We're going to keep moving along, though. We go to the Room of Requirement, which I keep forgetting about. Oh, look at this, though. Look. This is like, they don't need this. They don't need to do this. But they do it, and I love it. This is probably lore. It's just so nice. It's a Bible right there. I'm just kidding. No. Can anyone tell me what this is? I don't know what it is. I know it's stained glass, but what is it? Who knows? Who knows? Beautiful. Yeah. There's a bunch of people behind me now. Kind of suck. They're all looking at me like I'm crazy. So I'm filming something that's not here. What if they put a Harry Potter animatronic right here? It'd be incredible. Okay. I got a couple of hyenas. I love it. So, the lady who guards the Gryffindor. Oh! Got me. Oh, no, no worries, guys. Come on through. You made. Oh, no, no worries at all. Enjoy, guys. Hold on tight, okay? Yeah, look at her. She's. Come on. Come on. You're not done yet. You got more to do. Hold on. No, we're soon. Oh, please, go through. Please. No worries.
Come on! I'm supposed to make it all here.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to password later.
I don't know what the password
is. What is this school coming to?
Well, I don't know.
Well, leave the number then.
You're letting muggles
in
here.
Okay,
fine. I'll keep going. All right, we're going. Also over here is kind of interesting. They show a bunch of clips of Harry throughout the years, newspaper-wise. Kind of fun. Then also, again, look it over here. It says no muggles. Too late. Look at all these books. I don't know what these books are. Actually, I lied. I do. You know, I was talking about the 9th book. This is 10 through 75. Yep, right here. Just out of reach. Look at that. I can almost get it. Billions of dollars could be mine. Oh, well. I don't think it's coming for me, guys. This is the one last major room before we have, like, go on to the attraction, which we won't be going on. But you can see the bench we were talking about beforehand. There you can see what it kind of looks like. Kind of swooping around. Yeah. Your safety briefing, as it were. Really intelligent way to divulge your safety in a Harry Potter-themed attraction. It's great. But also, oh, I just pieced this together. So we are in the Gryffindor common room. I've never even thought about that. Oh my gosh. Here's the big fireplace. And there's the big emblem. Come on, Jim. Bring it together here. Love it. So cool. Yeah. But if you look up, just like look up and appreciate this, guys. Like, it's just so much. So much theming. They didn't need to, but they did. And you know what? I love it. I really do. My goodness. Yeah. So good. Okay, tell me guys. Armoire? Is it an armoire? What is that? I don't know. Like a giant cabinet? Who knows?
Change glasses.
There we go.
And magic wand.
And also down the way here a little bit, you can see him way in the distance there. The sorting hat as you go into the room of requirement. Pretty cool. He gives you some more safety information. 48 inches to ride this. So great to hear a Brit say inches. Also, there's way up to, is that the boys? Is that where the boys go up? And then it's like,
Happy Christmas, Harry. Happy Christmas, Ron.
Kind of thing? I don't know. All right, up here I'm about to tell them that I am just doing the castle walkthrough. I'm just doing the castle walkthrough. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. There's the hat right there. So cool. I don't want to get in the way anymore, so we're going to sneak out the side. Let's see. If that was the wardrobe, the Bogger comes out in the 3rd movie? Oh, maybe. I don't know. That's a great question. Cool. You can actually see the ride vehicles here as we go into the Room of Requirement. Yeah, it's pretty cool. But those things, so it's basically, like I said before, it's like you're on the top of a cherry picker. It's moving around, if you guys know what I'm talking about. And then you can see all the candles and everything. Very magical. It's very cool. I just get pretty sick of it. I did it earlier today, and I clenched and like my whole body, and I was okay. Which is always something you want on an attraction. Like, tense up your whole body, you'll be fine. But now we're going into the most magical portion. Filch's Emporium, aka the gift shop. And here are all the fantastic beasts. Mom, I think you'd like this one. He likes to steal things, keep them for himself. So cute. Little Hedwig action. I like it. Oh, so they've got the Gryffindor lion, Hufflepuff, Ravenclaw, Slytherin. That's just smart marketing. Aragog down here. Hermione's cat, Crookshanks. Oh, is that Fang? Yeah, Fang over here. Fang, my boy. Love it. Wow, I guess I'm more of a Harry Potter fan than I have realized. I am a fan of Harry Potter. I really am. I like the Wizarding World. And again, we've got owls. Anybody in the chat know what a group of owls is called? Let me know. I'll be very impressed. Anybody up for a little wizard's chest? Pawn to C2. I don't know. I like chess. I don't know how to call it out, though. Ooh. Oh, baby. Look at this right here. This is a cup for a Gryffindor. $21, $4 cheaper than a chocolate frog. Keep that in mind, everybody. We're basing everything off chocolate frogs. I can't believe it was $25 for a chocolate frog. Must be like a special chocolate frog. Wisdom, learning, wit. It's Ravenclaw. Patience, dedication, loyalty. Hufflepuffs. You love them. I think the world needs more Hufflepuffs. A hoot. No, Joe. That was close. Any other guesses? We're going to do a little education on tonight's show. Joe, by the way, I don't know if Haley's around, but hi, Haley. Hi, Clark. Mom nails it. Parliament. You know what that gets? A little dance. You did it. Nice job. You did it. You're doing it. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Just making a fool out of myself. In Filch's Emporium. I can't even take this. I didn't know they had this. This is Dobby.
Master gave Dobby a sock. Master gave Dobby clothes.
That's what it is. How hard is it to do Dobby and, like, have, like, Gollum also in the world at the same time and not have them be too similar? I know they're not the same, but this is, like, Gobby's, like, blue album. I can't even look at it. It's just, just the half and the... free the house elves. I don't know if I've seen anybody wear these. This is... See, look at this. You get the sword and everything. Okay, I have a little gripe. Godric Gryffindor's sword in Chamber of Secrets, not as cool as I want it to be. Oh, Joe, the merch here is amazing. The merch, Harry Potter merch, besides Jurassic, is the best. Dobby's the best, but that shirt is pretty. See, everything. Look at this, the little tank top. I look so cute in this. Okay, no. What is this? I don't even know what I'm looking at. What is this? These pants? Oh, they're pants.
Okay. It's Dobby.
People are looking at the Dobby thing laughing at it. That's good. Oh, you get a little bedazzled Hufflepuff action? Bedazzled Ravenclaw? Feels like the Hufflepuff and Ravenclaw stuff is like everywhere. It's like, we're popping off here. Get like a little throw pillow, if you like. Throw these across the room. On your own time. Oh, the Triwizard Cup. Oh my gosh. I can just have it. Can I just have it? Oh my goodness. Mostly plastic. Joe always says, if you have to ask how much it costs, you can't afford it. This one costs $19.95, $5 cheaper than a chocolate frog. Okay. Oh, see here, look at this. This is the Gryffindor, they call it Gryffindor sword. But it's so thin. Like, this is supposed to be like the legendary sword of Godric Gryffindor. And this isn't the exact same one, right? But Harry probably could have used a Wyvern Jawbone Greatsword against the Basilisk instead of that dinky little sword. See? Caden gets it. That would have been amazing. Caden, I hope the missus has been satisfied with all this. See, now this is good. This is good. I love this. These two look kind of the same, but they are distinct. Like, it's... That is nice. This is reminiscent of the kind of English dragon. Oh, I like this. This is good. This is to... Wow. You could fend off many things with that. Mostly thirst. The merch. Whoever does the Wizarding World merch is just... Look at these. More suspenders. You'll never need another suspender in your life. We gotta see if our name's on the board. How do you guys do this too? Every time you see these, it seems like the most self-indulgent thing. $15, $10 cheaper than the chocolate frog. Jimmy, oh my gosh. All right, guys. Do I get the Jimmy? No. It's tempting. Jimena? I noticed that Jimmy and Jimena, there's a lot of those. So not a lot of Jimmy and Jimena's coming in here buying. But look at this though. Oh, look at this. Julian and Julie, gone. Gone. Okay. Sneak around over here. Hello. This is great too. Oh, nice little Fantastic Beast stuff and where to find them. Newt Scamander. Look at these things. All right. You guys know the names of all these guys? All right. I'm gonna help you out. Don't worry about it. Okay. So this one's Steely Magoo. All right. Steely McGee. Magic Firebird. This is Snappo, Steely McGee's brother, Twig Guy, and Hippogriff Jr. There you go, everybody. Oh, we didn't go to Ollivander's. We should go to Ollivander's. Oh my gosh, this is... I love stuff that isn't, like, specifically about one of the houses. Hogshead in Hogsmeade. This is the front of the shirt. Down there. That's the back. That is great, because at first glance, you don't know it's like a theme park thing or any type of fandom. That is amazing. I love that. That's so cool. But yeah, this is right after. Uh-huh. I did notice something back over here. I think that's one of the Death Eater, like, masks over there, which changed up a little bit. Oh, sure, that'd be great! Yeah! If you don't mind. Oh my gosh, Death Eater mask. Sounds good. Wow. How cool.
Come with the stand and you're able to actually wear it.
Oh, you put it on too? Amazing. That's so cool. Is it for 110?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. That's Lucius Malfoy's Death Eater mask.
I thought it was Bellatrix.
Oh, and Bellatrix. Okay. Gotcha.
I can't go to
That's okay. That's so cool. Oh, and you got the umbrella, tiny goblin sword that goes showing. The bust of the basilisk. You got some cool stuff back here.
Yes, and almost everything back here is for sale.
Cool. What's your favorite?
One thing, weapons. Just
the weapons.
I like weapons.
Weapons are so, Brandy, totally. Yes. Yes.
Right now, this item.
Oh.
It's the blood contract between Grindelwald and Dumbledore.
Yeah, totally. Hey, that's a big deal right there. That's so cool. My gosh.
That one is $72.
$72. Okay, cool. Brandy, I need to know, what do you think of Godric's sword? The Gryffindor sword. What do you think? Because you're a weapons person.
It looks good to slash, but that's right now all of them.
Good to slash. See? I agree. Maybe a little stabbing, but, you know. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Have a nice day.
You too. Take care. Aw. That's amazing. Cool. Did you guys see all that? That was wonderful. What did I miss? I really can't tell if you were joking or if that was the creature's real name. No, those are jokes. A deadpan humor. Oh, night has fallen. Look at that. You can see up there. You can see the flight of the hippogriff. Amazing. That's so cool. Yeah. Okay, I'm going to pop over to the side here for a second. Say hi to everybody. Again, thanks everybody for being here tonight. Hi. Hello. I know it's pretty dark. This is so dark over here. Just hanging out by this lamppost. Okay. Go somewhere. You can't see me at all. Okay, let me go somewhere else. Woo. Hi. Yeah. Looks good to slash, I'm dying. It's funny too because like Harry used it to stab the basilisk, so it's that was a very diplomatic answer. She's not gonna talk poorly about it. She's trying to make a sale. And you know what? I think she did a good job. I think she did a good job. Yeah.
We're gonna go to the
Here, I'm gonna go right over here. Here we go. What else do you guys wanna see? I have no idea how much battery I have left. Hold on, let me check. Oh, we're doing okay. We're doing okay. Hi everybody, thank you so much for tuning in. I know for some of you it's a little bit later on because I'm on Pacific time. So like for mom and stuff, mom, if you want to go sleep, you go sleep. She's probably like, yeah, I'm out. Oh, there we go. Hold on. Ah, so cool. Look at this though, oh my gosh. There we go. Oh, a castle. So pretty. So pretty, look at that uplighting. And they actually do a castle show at night, so what you're seeing is not necessarily uplighting, I should say. These are projections of lights on there. It's really cool. I don't know when they're gonna do the projection show tonight. I think they'll probably do one, though, at some point. Yeah, it's so cool around here. And again, the camera kind of makes it brighter than it is, but it's pretty dark around here. Very atmospheric. I really love to see it. You love to see it, as they say. You love to see it. Yeah. 8 o'clock. Oh my gosh, I only have an hour left in the park. Look at that. What do you guys want? Do you want to see a little more of Harry Potter stuff? Should we go down and see some Jurassic? What do you guys want to see? Tell me,
baby.
I gotta know. Tell me, baby, because I need to know. I need to know. It's kind of work out here. It's like 1 hour with my arms straight. I feel like I'm right in the way of people. I'm gonna go over here. I'm not away. The screams. I love the screams. So good. Oh my gosh. There we go. I'll be back around. I like some smoke go off. Oh, are they doing a late night version of Waterworld? Oh, that would have been cool to see. Maybe. I don't know. Would they do that? They might. They very well may. Joe wants to see Jurassic stuff. Alright, Joe gets what Joe wants. I'm getting Joe to watch a live stream. This is almost unheard of. Oh my gosh, everybody's waiting here for the show. I'm in the way.
There's a reason why I don't like to go.
Surprise us. I unironically want to see what the bathrooms are like. This probably wouldn't go well on there with the camera. Yeah. So, Caden, they actually do have Moaning Myrtle in there, which is super weird. Especially the guy's bathroom. Oh my gosh, they are doing Waterworld. Oh, a late night showing of Waterworld would be sick. Do you guys want to watch the light show or do you want to go on Jurassic? Or both. could totally do both. Eclipsed an hour live streaming. This is so much fun. So different than the live streaming I'm used to, which is on Twitch, where I'm just playing a game. This is like so interactive. It makes the time fly so quickly. So thank you guys so much for being here. Thank you for commenting. It means so much to me. It really does. Okay, light show. All right, we're gonna do light show. We'll probably do Jurassic for Joe. We'll see how long he sticks around. We're gonna pop into Ollivander's. I said we were doing Ollivander's, and I feel like a bad, bad boy if I don't. A bad boy. Now, Katie, you guys know Katie. Twin sister Katie. Might be watching this future. She keeps threatening to purchase a wand for me so I can just walk around and use it. I think we can go in this way. There we go. I'm in. Light show. Some more merchandise over here. Yeah. Give it. Oh, alumni. I thought it said aloha. Sorted. You got sorted, dude. Good stuff. Okay. Here we go. Let's go check those wands. Now, if you want to purchase a wand here, you can purchase one of the legacy wands, I think they're called, which are featured in the films. So, like, for instance, if you wanted Professor Lupin's wand, you could get a version of Professor Lupin's wand. I don't think you can make your own. Oh, this is just a Death Eater one. That's what Joe would be rocking. I don't know if I get to choose one. Peter Pettigrew, that's a fun one because it's like a snake. I wonder if he always had it like that. Ooh, I do like the white bone of Voldemort's. That's pretty metal. These wands cost an amount that I don't know.
Give us a second, Maxine.
Oh, hold on a second. It is, hold on. Magic number is cut off. Voldemort, what if I just want to buy your wand? $59. It's gonna cost you a couple chocolate frogs, alright? Boxer stacks up poorly, but it goes with the vibe perfectly. Yes, exactly. So these are all uneven for the most part. Like, and they're just, yeah, kind of shoved in there. You know, Harry Potter and the Wizarding World has such an aesthetic to it that I don't think you can recreate, but it's so wonderful. It's so cool. So check this out. We'll head over here. See a little bit more. Want to. Hello. And you can like look up the stairs. We have more wands. So good. And then over here, a ton more wands. I don't know. Maybe one day I'll get one. I'm not sure which one. By the way, fun fact about me, because Hermione was such a weird name when someone told me how to say it, I thought all the names were weird. So I thought Ginny Weasley for the longest time as a kid was Ginny Weasley. I thought that was a hard G, like good. It's a little self-indulgent. Speaking of good though, Luna. Love good. Xenophilius Love good. That was my nickname in college, Xenophilius. Joke and corroborate. I don't even know what these are. Oh, so you can get just like basic wands. Like this is an ash-based wand. So like if you like Pokemon, get ash. Birch, you know, Professor Birch. Again, Pokemon. See, a little bit of Pokemon merch in here, which is nice. Kind of strange, but it's the truth. Everybody buying wands? I'm gonna sneak out the back though. Oh, that's Ollivander's. Ollivander's. A lot of people wait out here. Oh, hello. Oh, they did. They just finished up with Waterworld and they just blew a bunch of stuff up and shot a plane over. So that being done means that this thing is about to pop off here, which everybody's waiting out front there. So I might stand right here and try to get a shot if we can. We'll see if this works. If not, then we'll move. And guys, again, please ask questions if there's anything you want to talk about. Y'all say hi quick. Mm-hmm. Oh, there we go. Hi, everybody. How you doing? Thanks for tuning in. Some of the Harry Potter music's a little melancholy, which I like because it kind of shows off Harry's solitude, especially when he's younger, when he comes to Hogwarts. Like, it's all so cool and amazing, but then everybody goes home for the holidays. Like, occasionally, like, there's like 1 or 2 years I think he's here by himself, and it's just kind of like, I totally get that, Harry. I totally get that. Does this not look like a postcard, though? Like a weirdly lit postcard? Ugh. Again, thanks for the likes, guys. I appreciate that. 4 likes? That's amazing. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. Amazing to me. And again, as I was saying before, while we're waiting for the show to start up, this is the extended queue over here for Forbidden Journey, something we walked through earlier. So if this queue goes all the way out here, this is probably the roughest part. Harry Potter game will randomly sort you into a house. How mad would I be if I was not a Gryffindor? Thank you for that question. That's a hard restart. Go again. Is it really randomly going to sort? Like, you know, and part of me wants to see the other common rooms. But really? Really, really? No. I'm a Gryffindor. I've been sorted. I have my Patronus. I will not settle. All right? Neither should you. If you get Slytherin and you're Ravenclaw, if you get Gryffindor and you're Hufflepuff, you just keep starting the game over again and again. Oh my gosh, we have 6 likes? Thank you. Thank you so much. More likes on this than most of my videos. Thank you. Thank you so much. Great question. Yeah. What else is excited about the Harry Potter game? I shouldn't say Harry Potter game. The Wizarding World game. What's my Patronus animal? Do you guys want to take a guess? It's actually weirdly specific. My mom might know it if she's still here. Yeah. Can we get Hogwarts in the background there? That's the light. Oh my gosh, this is good. Guys, this is so much fun. Honey Badger. No, not a dragon. No. Anybody else want to take a guess? If not, that's okay. Not a Honey Badger, that is hilarious. Honey Badger came after Hufflepuff, but now that Honey Badger exists, I still think Hufflepuff is more like loving, you know, and caring and supersedes Honey Badger. Blue-footed. He's trying to trip me up. No, my Patronus is a Newfoundland, a really, really big dog, big black dog, big furry dog. Fun fact, mom knows about this, we almost got a Newfoundland back when I was a little kid, but we tried it out one for a trial weekend, and then, a trial weekend, and there was just so much slobber, but mom, that's perfect, yeah. So I'm a Gryffindor, whose Patronus is a Newfoundland. I feel like that really is me, like through and through. So I feel good. I like that. Yeah. Let me know what your Patronus is. If you guys have never taken the, I think it's like on Pottermore. That's where I did it through. Are people still using Pottermore? I don't know. Oh. Stuff might be happening. Hold on a sec, guys. Let me flip your own. Oh. If this is a bad shot, we'll move. But this might be a really cool shot. Music. Oh my gosh. Getting goosebumps. I've heard it today, but copyright claims coming in hot.
Good evening.
Hello.
I'm the Hogwarts sorting hat.
Sweet.
There's nothing I can see. So try me on and I will tell you where you are.
Wait, if there's a Hogwarts sorting hat, does that mean Beauxbatons and Durmstrang have them? Yeah. John Williams not one of the greatest composers of all time. Like, come on. Some Ravenclaw action? I think. Yeah. Oh, they light the trees up too? Oh, that's a beautiful little effect, Universal. Oh my gosh. The trees! This is incredible! Oh my god! Oh! A little Hufflepuff action. Look at that badger. How about Gryffindor comes up? They start playing metal. you guys looking for the ride? Yeah. It's actually you have to go around off the left and then cut back through. Some lost patrons. Bum, 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 bum. Slytherin bringing the percussion. Oh, this is actually a cool shot. I hope you guys can see it. Yeah, baby. Gryffindor! Woo! Yeah! Classic Gryffindor response. Ravenclaw. Okay, that Gryffindor music probably should have been Ravenclaw music. Yes. Oh, yes! Crank it! Good. It's like constant goosebumps. Like, I'm going to the merch store. Let's go. Cool. Look at these lights. That. I don't. Like, I knew this was gonna happen. And I was like, yeah, it'll be like a little light show. That was great. That was really good. And it's mostly John Williams music. So it's like, that's the thing that like stirs the passion. Super good. That was super cool. Universe, well freaking done. If you get to a fireworks show, you do one of those. Oh my gosh. Woo! That was great. I hope I wasn't too loud, just screaming for Gryffindor, hooting and hollering. I like it. I like it a lot. That was fantastic. Yeah, and you can still see it up here. It's kind of golden. So good. The secret John sauce. You put John Williams on anything, you've elevated it. You've elevated it by like 8 points. Guys, did you know that the first, okay, just a little side note quick. Home Alone didn't have John Williams attached originally. Then he jumped on board. Listen to the beginning of Home Alone and you feel the tingle. You feel the tingles. So good. All right, now we're gonna head down through the secret path down to Jurassic because I probably need to wrap up the stream here so I can finish up the vlog. I only have 45 minutes left. Oh my gosh. That was so cool. I got to experience it with you guys. That's amazing. Again, I want to know what your Patronuses are. Put the Patronuses up. I need to see them. Now we're going to walk into Springfield, which I had a great meal at tonight. Coming up on the vlog. Well, eventually. I have plans for Springfield. No offense, Springfield, but I have plans for you. Also, if you go off to the right here, this is where the studio tour is. The last tour already departed, though. But I went on one recently at night. It was actually really cool. Some of the stuff up there, very scary. Yeah. Then over here, you can actually see what's filming on the lot, which is really cool. I'd like to check this out. Or I like to keep it. Weiss says, my spirit animal is a goat, so I guess my Patronus is probably a goat. Cool. Yeah, probably. Dr. Nix, if you can put it in, we can take it out. Okay. Well, Springfield. Now, Springfield is very well themed. It's themed about as well as it can be. Oh, there's Sid breaking out of prison. Sideshow Bob's over here too, breaking out of prison. Prison is not very secure. Check this out. A little bit of that crusty land. Looks really nice at night. 40 minutes, yeah, this is a slow loader. Mom's a manatee. Mom, I love you so much. You're definitely a manatee. Oh my gosh. I love it. Oh, good call, Ma. We're gonna go to the lower lot, my favorite part of the park. I haven't been here all day. I've also not been in the park all day, but I can't wait to show you guys this. This is so cool. Manatees are rad, thank you. Yes. Hello.
Hey, how's it going, buddy?
Good, how are you?
Very good.
I like being called buddy, I'll take it. Now we can look over Burbank. We can see all the movie studios. It's gonna be great. Now, to get to the lower lot, we need to use four, count them, one, two, three, four different escalators. Escalators, escalators, escalators. I love it. Here we go. Time to go down the escalators. I'm gonna switch this to myself just because I can. Hi. How you doing? I like being here. It feels good. If I can't get to Disneyland, it's like, come to Universal. It's like, okay, pretty good. Pretty good. Now we're going to stop off over here, and I'm going to show you one of my favorite views that I've seen in the city so far since I moved down here. It's really nice. It's like, so cool, so cool. So this is just the first escalator, and I don't think it's even the longest one. Might be one of the shortest, actually. Again, thank you guys so much for being here tonight with me. I really do appreciate that so much. It's so nice. People from all over, too, you know? It's great. Okay. All right. We're going to do a dramatic reveal, because it'll be more fun that way. We'll go over here, so we have more escalators we're going down. Do I like Universal or Disney better? Hey, Medley, how you doing? I'm a Disney boy. I grew up on a steady diet of Disney, so it's Disney. I like Universal a lot. I think we're getting along just fine, but like Disney is a love, like a love, a love, a love, a love. Okay, are you guys ready for this? Here we go. Check this out. Yeah, look at this. Okay, I want to point some stuff out to you guys because it's really cool. This is Burbank and probably Glendale over there, some other stuff down the way, but this is where a very, very big amount of all the things you watch is made. Okay, now let me show it and prove it to you. This is all Universal Studios right down here. Sound stages. I may have worked at these recently. Not a speaking role, but just want you to know. But behind that, over here, so there's like a bright light right there that you can see. If you go over here where my finger is pointing, Warner Brothers, okay? Behind that, there's another building. That's ABC. That's where Disney is. Disney Studios. So Universal, Warner Brothers, Disney, all right here. Here. Like, that is so much stuff. That's so... Think of how many movies and shows have been made here. And commercials and music videos and like... Oh my gosh. It's a lot. Also over here, this is where the tram tour comes down. And you can look up and there's Springfield. There's the Simpsons ride. But yeah, the camera won't do it justice, but this is, I think it's San Gabriel Valley, maybe? But yeah, lots of stuff is made here. It's really cool. Oh, forgive me. Medley, what do you like better, Universal or Disney? I'm sorry, I did not ask. I need to do that. Here we go. Look at this. Fashion. Thank you. Well, Kate and I've got so much fashion, I moved out here for it, so. One of these days. Yeah, it's gonna be great. It's gonna be wonderful. Those streams will be nuts. yeah, but no, I love it. Oh yeah, so here, let me show you another thing. This can kind of help you if you're not sure about like what you're looking at. You come over here. Right over here. Medley, you wanna visit Universal? You totally should if you get the chance. You totally should. But yeah, so the world famous backlot, King Kong, which is right over here. It's actually one of their, in a soundstage. And then Warner Brothers and then Walt Disney Studios. Again, they're right back over here, not very far away at all. Warner Brothers is expanding 16 more soundstages. Universal over here, they're adding 4 more. It's kind of hard to see at night, but if you look over here, you can kind of see these lights right here. So down over here in the dark, that's where those soundstages are gonna be. Oh, and they're doing American Ninja Warrior down there. I actually saw that as a background opportunity recently. So yeah, they're doing that down there. You can see all those lights and stuff. Let's see if I can point this out to you. See where the blue is kind of going off? Yeah, over here, this stuff. They're filming American Ninja Warrior. It makes it look like it's downtown Los Angeles. It is not. It is not downtown Los Angeles. And guess what? It's a night shoot, which in the business means you're working from midnight to about 6:30 in the morning. So yeah, No, thank you. No thanks. For me personally, night shoots are not not the most fun. We're gonna look from up here. It's a little scary, the height. Here, this is the lower lot. This is where pretty much all of the sound stages are, but right here we're looking at one sound stage. This is for the Mummy, though. Mummy roller coaster attraction. Over here, Transformers. And over here, Super Nintendo World coming 2023. I'm really hoping I can be there for the debut of all that. I'm so excited. But then down here, Jurassic. We're coming, baby. Oh, baby, I love you so much. But as you can see, we've got 1, 2, 3 more escalators. There's one more down here that we have to go down. So let's get to it. I love it. And again, if you guys have any questions or anything, please let me know. I do answer a lot of these questions too in the blogs, so just, I hate to be redundant, but I'm happy to answer anything you guys have. Yeah, this is good. I just realized this recently, there's this new movie coming out called Firestarter, which is a remake of Carrie, which I think is a remake or an imagining of the story of Carrie. I don't know, it's a lot. It's hard for me to keep it straight. How are we doing on battery, though? This is great. Oh my gosh. Thank you, guys. So much fun to stream with you. Just gotta dance over the copyright music. Yep. Dance. Play bodies. They never play bodies. I wish they would. Now the question is, do you guys want to go on Jurassic, or do you want to go into the merch shop, or do you want to do the ride and then the merch shop? Let me know. Let me know. The escalators, they're kind of like a little ride in and of themselves, too. I enjoy it. It's fun. Oh, yeah. Fun little story. I got lost once on the Universal lot and almost ended up in Super Nintendo World. can you stream the ride? Oh, I did the other day, buddy. If you want to see a stream of the ride, baby, that's exactly what you're going to get. Okay, you can go. We're going to go tell Indominus we love her to her face. They won't let me off the ride to give her a smooch. I wish I could. Love that Indominus Rex. I told people this. It's not that I don't like the Jurassic World movies. I do. But this ride makes me love them even more. It, like, really endears you when you have the physicality of it. Yeah, so there's Firestarter. Ambulance. With LA in the middle. See? Movie coming out. Black Phone? I think that's been out for a while. And then The Bad Guys. That's coming out soon. People keep telling me I'd be good as a villain in a movie or a TV show. Do I put off villain vibes? Guys, be honest with me. Yeah, it's just so pretty here. Bill, Janice, and Nisi, you guys gotta come out here. I almost said Mary. Everybody gotta, you gotta come out here. If you come to the parks, let me know. I'll try to pop by. Say hi. Oh, they're playing low. I know the song. Yeah, we're gonna get copyright claimed anyway. How's that fun? There we go, that's it. I hope you guys can hear that, otherwise I just look like a complete psycho. Okay, we want you so badly. Just took. Oh, well, you just took a Patronus quiz. Let's see. Oh, here we go. Patronus quiz. I'm a fox terrier. Cool. My mom is a dapple gray mare. Whoa. Very specific. Dapple gray mare. I like it. Now look at this. This is the show building. The main show building, I should say, for Jurassic. I'm gonna sneak past here. I can't impress upon you how big this actual building is. Look at that. Oh, baby. The T-Rex, still the iconic logo for Jurassic Park. But this is an 85-foot drop. They say vertical. I don't know about that. We'll actually go down the stairs so you guys can see stuff. Oh, they might be having Blue come out and say hi. I love Blue. Blue and I are old pals. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Blue and I actually, we did our senior thesis together. Yeah. Mammals and why they can't run faster. It was crazy. Yeah, it was really fun. It's hard for me to keep up, though. Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's a Jungle Cruise level joke right there for you, ladies and gentlemen. Not a Frasier level joke, but a Jungle Cruise. Oh, I smell the bromine. I'm being drawn to it. All right, when's Blue coming out? 8:30? What time is it? 8:28. Oh my gosh, we can go say hi to Blue first. Oh, they're splashing down. We're gonna say hi to Blue because we love Blue. We'll just do it from here, maybe. Unless, did you guys want an up-close encounter with Blue? She's gonna be coming out here. And I do love that Blue. Maybe we'll do that. We'll just go say hi. I'll show you guys the boats coming down too from the drop. That's gonna be us soon. Check this out. See that darkness? That's where we come out of. Oh, see this water? Want to avoid that. Wait for it. Wait for it. Usually this waterfall's going. It's not as deep today. Interesting. Oh, here we go. Brace yourselves, ladies and gentlemen. Woo! Oh, baby, there's like barely anybody on that one. Oh, maybe we'll get our own boat. Get your own boat. Get your own boat. That'd be great. Again, thank you guys for sticking around. An hour and a half. That's so amazing. So amazing anybody's still here. Thank you. Thank you so much. So Blue should be like walking out. Uh-oh, I see some movement. See that? The lights and the shadows. Oh. Here we go. Look at how the water reflects off this. It's so great. I love this part of the park. And this was actually helped and designed by Steven Spielberg himself back in 1993. Now you might be wondering, Jimmy, 1993? Really drank? Glad to hear it. Oh, that was a full boat right there, ladies and gentlemen. Rock on, rock on. I'm glad to hear that, Caden. Appreciate it. Thank you so much for the feedback. Let me know how I can make it better. But Steven Spielberg made this in conjunction with film. Oh, and they had a raft portion in the book that he didn't put in the movie, so he made the ride simultaneously with the movie. That's all I wanted to say.
Ladies and gentlemen, in the latter part of the Cretaceous period, dromaeosaurids ruled the land using their speed, agility, and vicious hunting techniques.
Yes.
Today, we invite the bravest among you to encounter the mightiest theropod of 75 million years ago.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Raptor Encounter.
Yes.
My name's Shannon. I'm one of the dinosaur handlers here at Jurassic World. Now, the training that you're going to be assisting us with today is an important part of our Raptor program. It allows us to study how the dinosaurs respond in proximity to humans.
Excellent.
And we're going to be using our favorite Velociraptor, Blue, because of her extreme intelligence, but also because of her empathy towards people.
Mm-hmm.
Which is unusual. Which is an unusual trait for dinosaurs to have. We're a little feistier than normal tonight. Now, this is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, but remember, we're also dealing with a wild animal, so please,
okay.
No sudden movements. For your safety, do not approach the raptor. If everyone follows the rules, you all will be perfectly safe. Don't worry.
Excellent.
We have everything. We have everything under control. She is definitely ready to come meet you all. Now, most importantly, folks, no matter what Blue does, I need you all to remain calm. As long as you are calm, she will be calm. All right, let's see what happens. Let's open the gates!
Oh, okay. Oh baby.
I'm talking.
Hey.
I'm talking. And Blue. Blue.
Oh. Oh. She wants to go for a ride.
It's on me. Blue. Hey.
She's a lot bigger in person.
And? I'm moving. Moving. Good! Good job,
Yay,
girl.
Blue! I love you, Blue. She's fine. She's good.
So, folks, as you can see, Blue's exhibiting a little bit of disobedience. She is responding to my voice commands, though. That's a good thing.
Excellent. Well,
so I hope you all read the fine print on those waivers we're supposed to sign. So we're going to start with our volunteers right here. Are you ready, my friend? Come on over. This is what we're gonna have you all do. Dad, do you wanna be the photographer? Or do you wanna have Mark do it here?
Mark's gonna be the photographer.
This is what we're gonna have you all do. I promise, buddy, you know what? If you
stand
right here, you see how Blue's eyes are on the side of her head? She can't even see you. So if you stand there, it's like you're invisible. There you go, that's perfect.
To be honest, like I know what's going on here, but it still scares me just a little bit.
Good. And right, you did it, buddy. Good job.
Oh, Blue.
See you next time, all right? Okay, who is next? Right,
a few
this
people
way.
In front of us.
Come on over.
Rape kid.
Come on over. Let's have you all sort of stand in a line. Just like a buffet.
Just like a buffet.
Now, for those of you folks just joining us, my name is Shannon. I'm one of the dinosaur handlers here at Jurassic World. And this lovely lady is Blue. Great job. We'll see you next
Blue
time.
Under the blue lights.
Okay, who is next? Come on over. Hang out right about
oh,
there.
Oh, I'm so excited. We'll say hi. I'll try to get a selfie shot, too.
Can you... No, no, I'm going to repeat this now. She wants to know if she can incorporate her leg injury into the photo. Do you know what that's going to do for our insurance rates, lady?
Oh, Blue's interested. Can smell. Good job, Blue.
But I am going to be telling this story all day tomorrow.
Yeah, exactly.
Great job, folks. See you later.
Thank you. Yeah.
All right, who is next?
Hi.
Right
hi, Shannon. How you doing?
How's it going?
Good. Hi, Blue. I want to come say hi. We have some people saying hi to you online. Oh, hey. Hey, Blue. Hi. How you doing? You're looking bigger than last time. I mean taller, not water, you know.
She's a good eater.
She's
a good eater.
She's a great eater, yeah. Blue, can we get a picture together after? Oh, no. Oh, hi.
I think that's about as close
okay.
to a yes as you're going to get.
Okay, thank you. Hi. Here we go. Here we go. Hi, Blue.
The Blue is a 3-year-old velociraptor.
Oh.
At her full height, she stands at around 10 feet tall.
Okay.
She is 14 feet long.
All right.
And she weighs around 1,000 pounds.
Thank you, Blue. All
right, we'll see
you're
you
so
later.
Great. Bye, Shannon. Thank you,
take
guys.
Care.
Appreciate it. Bye, Blue.
Don't worry. That was not at you, I promise. Come on up.
They actually have a Triceratops in the burrito they used to.
Right,
that was really cool.
There.
What did I miss, guys? What did I miss?
In between you and the raptor.
That job, yes. The person is, yeah. I would love to see him. So cool. Hi, Blue.
Yeah,
Blue's amazing.
All
right, we're going to go ride Jurassic World. What time is it? How much time do we have? 8:35? Okay. We're going to do this, and then I need to wrap it up and ride it again for the vlog. We're moving. We're shaking. It's going to be great. I'm going to use my express pass, and I'm not going to need it. All right, here we go. Beautiful. Wasn't that cool, guys? I love meeting Blue. Also, Sierra's really good, too. Sierra's their infant or juvenile raptor. Super duper cute. This music always makes me want to do a little bit of this. You know what I mean? Like the percussion. Oh. Yeah, it's too good. It's too good. All right. Here we go. It's time for a little ride.
Okay.
Perfect. Hello. Thank you so much. Thank you. All right, we're gonna ask for the back because if I get front, we're gonna get wrecked. This is the second time I'm doing this with a phone.
Please pay attention to these important instructions and precautions.
Hi. Just one. Can I get the back? Whatever. Thank you so much.
You are going to embark.
Oh my gosh, nobody here.
You will be heard in those five people.
Here we go.
When the gate opens,
I think
step into the bush.
Perfect.
Using the handrails.
This is great.
And the seat as step.
Okay.
Moving all the way.
Walked on. This is gonna be really fun. Okay. This is gonna be good. You guys have any questions? This is the ride I am the most familiar with. I love it. My one day record so far, I was using Express. 11 times. Got on 11 times in one day. Here we go. It's a little bit wet. Admittedly, it's a little bit wet. Alright. Alright, let's pull the lap bar down here. Okay. Sorry, there's a little bit of light in the face there. Thank you, Justine. I thought we were taking off right away. That would have been amazing. Again, if you have questions or anything, let me know, guys. We got in here at the right time, I think. Perfect. Bye. Thank you. I like getting a wave. There we go. A beautiful night here. Isla Sorna. Wait, Nublar. Wait. Nublar. Yes, Nublar. Sorry. Sorna was Site B, I think. My bad. Look at the moon. Alright, guys. Who's ready for a little bit of fun? Oh, there's Nintendo World, by the way. Look at it. Woo! Speaking of blue. Now?
A vast ocean was home to an explosion of life.
Look at that skeleton.
At the top of the food chain sat the Mosasaurus, apex predator
boss,
of the deep.
You are clear for entry.
Oh, yes. And the screens are showing the nighttime variant, which I love to see. Hard to tell on the actual video. This is darker than it normally is. Front row getting wrecked. So this room is massive. The music's good. Got the rumble too of the Mosasaurus going underneath the boat. It's really nice. The only thing I want is a Mosasaurus animatronic, but that would kind of throw the whole ride off, turn it into Jaws.
Sparky, baby, yeah.
All right, here we go. The Oh, coming in hot. Oh. Dino, stop. Stop it. Everyone, I said the Indominus was fast. Yeah, real fast. Hi, Ando. Hi, baby. Oh, she just wanted to give me a smooch.
Can you hear me? I've said help. Keep an eye out for me.
Now, do you want to see the drop, or do you want to see me? I don't know. Tell me what's better. What's my left? Oh my. There she is. Oh. I love so much. Oh, yes, stop, it's right here. Stop, stop, stop. Yes, 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 perfect. Oh, look at her. Oh my god. Gaming is worse, right? Still with the meet and greet. Amazing. I love it. Oh my goodness. We'll go in the Jurassic merch store here. We got a few minutes.
Welcome back. As your boat enters the station, please raise your arms and your ramp bar will raise automatically. Exit to your right and enjoy the rest of your day here at Jurassic.
Again, I've covered this a lot in the vlogs. So it looks probably better there, but it's so cool to bring you guys along with me. Thank you so much. Thanks for supporting me, guys. I appreciate you hanging out and liking it and everything. Oh, it's so cool. Thank you. I was worried the phone was gonna fly out. That's more of the terror. I barely felt the drop. I've done it that many times. Little Jimmy would have been terrified. All right, hey, thank you. Thank you, Caden, and Mrs. Or Caden's wife, whose name escapes me, but hello, good night, sleep well, thank you. Thank you for being here.
Welcome back. As your boat enters the station, please raise your arms, and your arms
yes.
Will raise automatically.
Sweet dreams, good night, Mom. Love you. Thank you for being here. Okay, we gotta get out of this now. We gotta go look at the merch. Again, if you're new around here, my name is Jimmy. This is my channel. You can check out the vlogs and whatnot. Just appreciate you being here. Yeah, thank you, know you. You're great, yeah. Arms up. Okay. Now into the most dangerous portion, the gift shop. Thank you. Okay, here we go, Jurassic Outfitters. Ugh, this store. All right, here, guys, the stretch goals, all right? I can't. Ooh, hey Blue, you miss me? I like a lot of that shirt, but can I put my own face on there? No, I don't have a problem with Chris. Chris is great. Chris, I aspire to be like Chris. He's in a few different things I want to be in. But look at this. Isn't that lovely? I love it. There's so much in this store I want to get. Yeah, so over here is where they talk about this, the 85-foot vertical drop. Close. You will get wet. I'm only a little bit wet. The Scorpius Rex, that is from Camp Cretaceous. If you guys haven't checked that out on Netflix, give it a watch. It's actually pretty good. I'm so tempted to buy some of these signs. I don't know, though. I'm not sure. Best trip ever. Dino Expert. Oh, Bumpy. It's also from Camp Cretaceous. Of course, the Supreme Reese's Peanut Butter. No. I love this store, though. Oh, they've got, like, a sweatshirt? Oh. That's pretty good. I just don't like putting sweatshirts on. Makes me claustrophobic. I've got quirks. Okay, look at this. This is nice though. Oh, this is a zip up? Come now. Okay, let's just write that, shall we? Ooh, tempting. I don't live with golden retrievers anymore, so I could buy this and it wouldn't turn golden. $57. Okay. But they still have the classic stuff there, which I love to see. Love to see that. I want to buy all these. all of these. I want all of them. I want to ride that someday. Toronto and Flyers, that is over at Universal Studios Florida over at Islands of Adventure. But you have to typically ride with a kid in the front, an adult in the back. But on some special nights, they let just an adult ride in the back. It's a really slow loader, but it's pretty cool. This is cool too, even though the Mosasaurus doesn't go over you. I don't know. And I like to show this off. I showed it off on the last live. Oh my lord, do they have Indominus. Oh, that's blue. Okay, I thought they had an Indominus stuffed animal. I was like, stream cuts automatically. So somebody showed me this. So they have the QR codes here. They don't work. But this one over here for Claire Deering's totally does. That actually works. A lot of the stuff on loan from Universal, NBC Universal archives. It's really cool. Yeah, I love that. I really do. Really, really. Dino Escape, Mega Destroyers. That's pretty cool. Carcharodontosaurus. Carcharodontosaurus? 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 I don't know. I tried. I used to be really good at dinosaur names. When I was a little kid, I could do that. Ooh. See all the names. Look at that. Like, how's that feel? How's that feel in the hand? Feels good. $29 good? $4 more than a chocolate frog? What is this? Free the dinosaurs?
Free the dinosaurs!
I became a dinosaur activist. Excellent. Okay. Well, there you go, guys. I gotta get out of here. That place is too... It's too tempting. It's way too tempting. I'm gonna walk upstairs here, and we'll say goodnight. Because my phone's gonna die. Oh, it's gonna die, like, right now. Okay. Maybe it's a better time to say goodnight right here. Oh, hold on. Again, thank you everybody for hanging out tonight. I hope you had fun. I know I did. It was so cool to spend this night and hang out in the Wizarding World and then come down here and do a little Jurassic. If you want to support me, just consider checking out the channel. That'd be great. I really do appreciate it. And for the people who've been liking this video, if I missed any like super chats or anything, I'm so sorry. But I don't think I did. But from the other night, thank you guys for the super chats. That was very kind of you. You do not need to do any of those things. Just let me know if you want to see more live streams, and we can make that happen. And again, like I said before, if you're watching in the future, I do want to know your Patronus. I need to know your Patronus. Of course, bye Nisi, bye Janice, bye Bill. Thank you for hanging out with me. I appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you, Joe. Thank you, Caden. Thank you, Medley. Thank you, everybody who's here tonight. I appreciate you. I'm sorry, I'm supposed to get this in the back. We got to get one more splashdown before we're done for the night. Well, it's going off. Come on. Ooh. So good. Anyway, I appreciate you guys. I'll let you know the next time I'm going to live stream. Probably going to be Tuesday from Disneyland, so Tuesday night if you want to come back next Tuesday night, which is April 12th. There you go. All right. Until next time, guys, love and hugs, and just remember to adapt and overcome. Bye-bye. Oh, there we go. I got to move the phone over. Oh, there we go. Bye, guys.